Hey, physique freaks, how's it going? Scott Tuzin on MetabolicMasterpiece.com. Today, I would like to discuss the latest muscle building research that was just published this month. And one study in particular that took a look at training to momentary muscular failure and rest pause training, which ironically, my last video that I published last week was about my four favorite variations of rest pause training, which really seemed to resonate with a lot of you, got a lot of likes, got a lot of comments and feedback from it. So thank you very much for all of that. And this totally makes my day to see new research come out that really backs up a lot of my theories and thoughts around some of these advanced aesthetic muscle building techniques. Now, when talking about training to momentary muscular failure, it seemed to be that 2014 was a year where there's a fair amount of muscle building coaches that were really steering away from training to failure. They're always instructing to at least leave one rep in the tank. And what I began to notice recently was that many of these coaches, they were the muscle building coaches that really believed that in order to gain muscle, the best thing to do is to just lift heavy shit. And as you know, that as a physique artist, as a physique athlete, I freaking love to lift heavy shit, but that's just a small portion of my overall training program design. I like to incorporate a variety of rep ranges, and I spend the majority of my time in the hypertrophy rep ranges, like 6 to 12 reps, sometimes higher repetitions. So when I listen to these muscle building coaches who say, who really focus their attention on just lifting heavy shit, I can kind of understand why they were saying, just leave a rep in there, always leave a rep in the tank, at least. Because when you're always lifting heavy shit, if you're always training to momentary muscular failure, you really do run the risk of injuring yourself, of kind of straining your joints and tendons, and some of them were thinking that you kind of run the risk of overtraining as well, which is, I guess, up for debate. But these are coaches that I highly respect. I really like them. I love their writing. I love their writing style. They put out some great content and information. And even though our philosophies don't jive, I like to incorporate a variety of rep ranges and training techniques, and they just like to lift heavy shit, I still have a great deal of respect for them. And I kind of found that I started adopting some of their thoughts and beliefs, and I started to leave a rep in the tank all the time. And to be honest, I wasn't getting as much enjoyment out of my workout. You probably noticed it in some of my videos. There was about a 2-month span where I was instructing to leave a rep in the tank. And it's amazing. You hear advice and you get pounded and pounded and pounded with it. And you don't believe it. You don't believe it. And finally, like, fuck, if I'm hearing it all the time, there's got to be something to it. And really, they didn't have any kind of research to back it up. And now we have research to the contrary. So what this research did, there was 79 subjects, I believe, and they divided into 3 groups. So one group was instructed to leave a rep in the tank. So you stop when you think your very next rep is going to reach momentary muscular failure. The other group trained right to momentary muscular failure. And the third group was instructed to leave a rep in the tank. So when you think your next rep is going to hit momentary muscular failure, rest for 5 to 20 seconds and then do as many more reps as you can. So rest, pause, train. What they found was the group that left a rep in the tank didn't experience much muscle gain at all. I think it was very insignificant. The group who did train to, they left a rep in the tank, just like the first group, but did rest pause training, they experienced significantly more gains than the group who didn't do rest pause training. So even though they left a rep in the tank, like the other group, they only rested for 5 to 20 seconds and then did as many more reps as can. That rest pause technique produced significantly more muscle gains than the rep in the tank group. The third group who trained to momentary muscular failure achieved the best results overall. So what would have really made my day was seeing a fourth group in there that trained to momentary muscular failure, rested for 5 to 20 seconds, and then did as many more reps as they could. So 2 rest pause groups would have been great, because that rest pause technique where you leave a rep in the tank, that's kind of geared more towards the strength athletes. Us bodybuilders, us natural bodybuilders and physique athletes, we tend to push ourselves harder, and I shouldn't say that, But we push ourselves to that momentary muscular failure when we're doing rest pause and only take that 5 to 20 seconds rest and go again. So it's kind of more in line with the natural bodybuilder. So I would really like to see those fourth group in there. Bottom line, I'm kind of rambling here to kind of wrap things up here. If your goal is muscle gains, hypertrophy, it's a great idea to train to momentary muscular failure, I'd say the majority of the time. And here's I think here's where the confusion sets in, because momentary muscular failure doesn't mean forcing out reps. It doesn't mean you get your last rep, and in order to get that last rep, you're like struggling on the bench press, you're using other muscles, supporting muscles to help get that weight up there, or you're rowing and you start to use momentum. No, training to momentary muscular failure is still quality form. So every rep is done, I don't want to say to perfection, but it's done with control and just in a controlled manner, done properly all the way through. It's not forcing out reps where you have a spotter helping you get that weight up. So that's a clear distinction, because there's a big difference between forcing out reps and training to momentary muscular failure. So I guess one of those points, and it's kind of like if you think back to, this is what we as bodybuilders have known this for decades and decades. And you listen to Arnold from way back then, he's always saying like, it's those last three reps where it's really that mind over matter. That's where you grow. Dude was right. I mean, he really was right. And when you see some of my previous videos where I really had that breakthrough a few months ago, where I was on that leg press machine and at 10 reps, the burn was kicking in. I felt like I could have given up at that point, but I pushed through it and ended up getting 20 reps. I worked through that burn. It was mind over matter. Those last 10 reps, that's where I was growing. I mean, when this group was, the first group was instructed to stop when you think your next rep is going to be trained to failure, a lot of us are probably pretty bad at judging that. I would have judged myself to think that the 11th rep, I was done, but I pushed out 10 more reps and got 20 in there. So really, and with good form, that's the key point as you're watching this video here. So train, really push yourself, test your limits, kind of step outside that comfort zone, but do it with good quality form. I think that's enough rambling for right now. I'm gonna include a link to the study down below. You can discuss this research with me, discuss your thoughts on training to momentary muscular failure, rest pause training. Hopefully we see more studies along these lines. Would love to hear your feedback. Catch up with you soon.